Find anything?
No. No place we could spend the night.
Hello? Anybody on the water?
Welcome to Pirate Island, me hearties! You're gonna have a whale of a time! Welcome to Pirate Island, me hearties! You're gonna have a whale of a time!
Welcome to heaven, me hearties! You're gonna have a whale of a time!
This place is falling apart. It's not gonna be easy to find shelter.
I'll handle this.
Big men do big things.
There we go.
Find anything better. Let's settle in for the night.
I'll get a fire going.
I'll make the fire here. That way we won't be smoked out.
the ropes. Pirates.
Alice?
Is that my gun or is that a different gun? I'm gonna just assume that's my gun. Maybe it isn't. I don't know. I guess we'll know someday.
Do you think we'll be like them someday?
Once we cross the border, we can start over. You can go to school. Maybe I'll find a job. We'll be like them. Like everyone else.
As long as we're together, that's all that matters.
Come on. Let's get you to bed.
I'm gonna go to sleep, you little squirt. You squirt of germs. And fleas, probably.
Don't worry. Luther and I will be right here. We need to get some sleep now.
Can you tell me a story, Kara?
I have 9,000 children's stories in memory. I should have one for you. This is a story about a knight who...
No, not a story like that. Make one up for me.
This is a story about a little girl who lived alone in a big, old house. She dreamed of being like all the other little girls, but... she was different. And that made her very sad. Then, she met a robot who was just as lost as the little girl. So they decided to run away together, to try to find a better life. They encountered great dangers along the way, but they wanted so badly to be free that they overcame all of them. Along the way, they met another robot who left his master to become their guardian.
How does the story end?
they reach the place they dream of and live happily ever after.
Stories always have happy endings. But real life isn't like that.
He done goofed.
Time to sleep. We have another long day ahead of us tomorrow.
Are you going to come say goodnight, Luther?
Yes. Yes, of course. Good night, Alice. Sleep tight. She's a sweet girl.
Yes. She's very brave. It's still snowing.
You have a long walk tomorrow. You better leave early if we want to avoid being seen.
Do you know what you're going to do when you reach Canada?
I haven't really thought about it. I've never been free before. Free? I like the sound of it. But I don't know what it really means yet. Kara, have you ever noticed anything about Alice?
No. What do you mean?
Hey guys.
Who are you? What do you want? Leave us alone!
Don't be afraid. We don't want to hurt you. We're just like you. Our name is Jerry. We were working here before the park closed. We didn't mean to frighten you, but sometimes humans come to hurt us, so we wanted to see who was there. What are you doing here?
We were looking for shelter for the night. We'll be gone tomorrow.
A little girl? We haven't seen one for a long time. Children used to love to come and see us. She looks sad.
The last few days have been difficult.
We have something to show her. Something fun. She'll love it. Does she want to see?
I don't think she's in...
Well, she should follow us, then.
Alice, I don't know if it's a good idea.
Come on, Kara!
I don't think you have any choice.
Be our guest! Little one can climb on board. The carousel is about to begin.
Teleportation.
First time I've seen her smile.
She hasn't had much to smile about lately.
Connor. Me and my boy Connor.
Nice view, huh? I used to come here a lot before.
Can I ask you a personal question, Lieutenant?
Do all androids ask so many personal questions, or is it just you?
Why are you so determined to kill yourself?
Some things I just can't forget. Whatever I do, they're always there, eating away at me. I don't have the guts to pull the trigger, so I kill myself a little every day. That's probably difficult for you to understand, huh, Connor? Nothing very rational about it.
You should stop drinking, Lieutenant. It could have serious consequences for your health.
That's the idea.
We're not making any progress on this investigation. The Deviants have nothing in common. They're all different models, produced at different times, in different places.
Well, there must be some link.
What they have in common is this obsession with RA9.
Exactly.
It's almost like some kind of myth. Something they invented that wasn't part of their original program.
Androids believing in God. Fuck, what's this world coming to?
You seem preoccupied, Lieutenant. Is it something to do with what happened back at the Eden Club?
Those two girls, they just wanted to be together. They really seemed in love.
They didn't want anything. They're deviants, end of story.
That's not exactly what I was trying to say.
What about you, Connor? You look human, you sound human, but what are you really?
I'm whatever you want me to be, Lieutenant. Your partner, your buddy to drink with, or just a machine designed to accomplish a task.
You could have shot those two girls, but you didn't. Why didn't you shoot, Connor? Some scruple suddenly enter into your program?
No. I just decided not to shoot. That's all.
But are you afraid to die, Connor?
You shouldn't do that, Lieutenant. Destroying me at this point would deal a blow to the investigation.
Oh no, I made a mistake. Oh, I made a mistake. Situation.
What'll happen if I pull this trigger? Nothing? Oblivion? Android heaven?
I doubt there's a heaven for androids.
Having existential doubts, Connor? Sure you're not going deviant too?
I self-test regularly. I know what I am and what I am not. Where are you going?
Get drunker. I need to think.
My hombre? I'm assuming the other ending is that he shoots.